Number 525, the strife is o'er. Number 525.
Servant Ted, whom you have called to journey to you, and since he hoped and believed in you, grant that he may be led to our true homeland to delight in its everlasting joys. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever. Now we have the first reading.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. Rise up in splendor, your light has come. The glory of the Lord shines upon you. See, darkness covers the earth, and thick clouds cover the peoples. But upon you the Lord shines, and over you appears his glory. You shall know that I, the Lord, am your Savior, your Redeemer, the Mighty One of Jacob. No longer shall the sun be your light by day, nor the brightness of the moon shine upon you at night. The Lord shall be your light forever, your God shall be your glory. No longer shall your sun go down on your moon. Withdraw, for the Lord will be your light forever, and the days of your mourning shall be at an end. The word of the Lord.
My light and my salvation, of whom should I be afraid? Of whom should I be afraid? The Lord is my light and my salvation, of whom should I be afraid? Of whom should I be afraid? The Lord is my light and my help. whom should I fear? The Lord is the stronghold of my life, before whom should I shrink? The Lord is my light and my salvation, of whom should I be afraid? Of whom should I be afraid? There is one thing I ask of the Lord, for this I long, to live in the house of the Lord all the days of my life. The Lord is my light and my salvation.
Reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, behold, I tell you a mystery. We shall not all fall asleep, but we will all be changed in an instant, in the blink of an eye, at the last trumpet. For the trumpet will sound, the dead will be raised incorruptible, and we shall all be changed. For that which is corruptible must clothe itself with incorruptibility, and that which is mortal must clothe itself with immortality. And when this which is corruptible clothes itself with incorruptibility, and this which is mortal clothes itself with immortality, the word that is written shall come about. Death is swallowed up in victory. Where, O death, is your victory? Where, O death, is your sting? The sting of death is sin, and the power of sin is the law. But thanks be to God, who gives us the victory through our Lord Jesus Christ. The word of the Lord.
John. Jesus said to his disciples, "Do not let your hearts be troubled. You have faith in God, have faith also in me. In my Father's house there are many dwelling places. If there were not, would I have told you that I'm going to prepare a place for you? And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come back again and take you to myself, so that where I am, you also may be. Where I am going, you know the way. Thomas said to him, Master, we do not know where you are going. How can we know the way? Jesus said to him, I am the way and the truth and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. The Gospel of the Lord.
I'd like to begin by offering my condolences to Ted's family, to his cousins, and to his extended adopted family, and to all friends who are here this afternoon for Ted's funeral mass. And on behalf of the family, I wish to thank all of you for being here, because it's important to be here in support of one another, and to pray for Ted. Death is hard, and it hurts. No matter when or how it happens, the death of someone you loved is hard. The grieving, the separation, the loss, and yet sometimes there can be relief that the agony is over. But yes, death is hard and it hurts. In a couple of months from now, we will celebrate Christmas. Of course, Christmas is typically a time of great mirth and joy, which doesn't go with the sadness of death and the sorrow and grieving of a funeral. But I mention Christmas to remind us that Jesus is coming into the world. His being born on that first Christmas was for this very reality, this very moment, to heal the real tragedy of life, which is what? Sin and death that man had brought into the world. At Easter, we praise the Lord Jesus for what he did to deliver us from the tragedy of sin and death, his own death on the cross and resurrection. And he suffered and died on the cross to defeat death for us and to open the gates of heaven. He made death's sting only temporary. And he did his work of redeeming us because of his infinitely deep, deep love for you and for me and for Ted. This is real cause for true hope. And so because of these facts, we are here to apply the infinite merits of Christ's sacrifice of this funeral mass to Ted's soul, and to praise and thank the Lord Jesus for all he did to redeem us and Ted. And we are here to recall Ted's sharing in the life and the love of the Lord. Of course, I know a person's life touches the lives of so many others in so many ways, and while no one can sum up a person's life in words, still we can say some of the ways the Lord Jesus blessed Ted in this life. Ted was born and raised in Cincinnati, went to St. William's Grade School and St. Lawrence Latin School. He was baptized into the grace and power of Christ. He was confirmed in the grace of the Holy Spirit. He was nourished on the real body and blood of Jesus in the Holy Eucharist, and that is the medicine of immortality. Ted graduated Elder High School class of 1949, and I learned yesterday that he was the valedictorian. That was out there on the board, too. Thanks, Penelope, for that piece of information. After high school, he attended the University of Cincinnati's Architecture and Design program. He began his career in the family's construction business, but found his true niche as an inspector and appraiser for housing and urban development. Ted had a keen eye and ear for the arts, too. He had an extensive art collection and loved going to the symphony, the opera, and the theater. He loved the arts. But mostly he loved you, and he was blessed with your love and care. Ted was devoted to his Catholic faith. attended Sunday Mass and daily Mass every day at St. Lawrence for years. I saw him there a lot. And I would also see him at the Prima Vista restaurant eating dinner. You know, he lived right there in the building above it. He was very personable, very sharp. I considered him a friend. Before Ted died, Ted was anointed twice. So he goes to the Lord well fortified with the sacraments of the church. You know, funeral masses, we place the pall over the casket to remind us of Ted's baptism in the Lord. And we have lighted the Easter candle here to remind us of the light of Christ which enlightened Ted's soul. Ted will be missed, but today we recommend Ted to the Lord, that the Lord might take him home to himself. So praised be the Lord Jesus forever, whose mercy and love never fails unto our salvation. Now let us stand, and we are going to offer our prayers of petition. Brothers and sisters, Jesus Christ is risen from the dead and sits at the right hand of the Father, where he intercedes for his church. Confident that God hears the voices of those who trust in the Lord Jesus, we now join our prayers to his.
The response is, Lord, hear our prayer. For Theodore, who has given the promise of eternal life in baptism, Lord, give Theodore peace and joy in our kingdom, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For Theodore, who went home to be with the Lord, may his homecoming be tender and joyful celebration, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
With concern, we lift up all those who are sick and dying, or who've lost a loved one. May their pain bring God's comfort, their discouragement his strength, and their loneliness his friendship, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for all the deceased members of our family. Even as we remember them in death, we express our gratitude for their lives, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And Lord, we pray for the safety of our armed forces serving at home and overseas. We also pray for our police and firefighters. Lord, please hold them in your loving hands and protect them. We pray that we may have peace in a troubled world, and we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
With trust, we lift up all those who have gone before us and all of us that are still on that journey. May we one day share in the joy of being together again in the dwelling place that the Lord has prepared for us. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer. Lord God, giver of peace and healer of souls, hear the prayers of the Redeemer Jesus Christ and the voices of your people, whose lives were purchased by the blood of the Lamb. Forgive the sins of all who sleep in Christ and grant them a place in the kingdom through Christ our Lord. Amen. And now we'll be seated for the offertory and the bringing up of the gifts.
Number 930, Taste and See, number 930.
At all times, praise.
to me.
Now let us stand and pray, dearly beloved, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. As we humbly present to you these sacrificial offerings, O Lord, for the salvation of your servant Ted, we beseech your mercy that he who did not doubt your Son to be a loving Savior may find in him a merciful judge, who lives and reigns forever and ever. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts, and let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. In him the hope of blessed resurrection has dawned, that those saddened by the certainty of dying might be consoled by the promise of immortality to come. Indeed, for your faithful Lord, life is changed, not ended, and when this earthly dwelling turns to dust, an eternal dwelling is made ready for them in heaven. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory as without end we acclaim. Created rightly gives you praise, for through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy, and you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself. Grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis our Pope and Dennis our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. Remember your servant Ted, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that he who is united with the Son, with your Son in a death like his, may also be one with him in his resurrection, when from the earth he will raise up in the flesh those who have died and transform our lowly body after the pattern of his own glorious body. To our departed brothers and sisters too, and to all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, when you will wipe away every tear from our eyes. For seeing you, our God, as you are, we shall be like you for all the ages and praise you without end, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him, with him, in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen, 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 amen.
Let us stand, and at the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil, and graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
With you, Dave. I will. Distributing Holy Communion right up here in front. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
Number 691 on Eagle's Wings, number 691. Channel of your peace, number 828.
Way.
this doubt's true faith in you. Make me a channel of your peace. Where there's despair in life, let me bring hope. Where there is darkness, only light. And where there's sadness, ever joy. Oh, Master, grant that I may never seek so much to be consoled as to console, to be understood as to understand, to be loved as to love with all my soul. Make me a channel of your peace. It is in pardoning that we are pardoned, in giving of ourselves that we receive, and in dying that we're born to eternal life.
Let us stand and pray. Lord God, whose Son left us in the sacrament of his body food for the journey, mercifully grant that strengthened by it, our brother Ted may come to the eternal table of Christ, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Please be seated, and now Penelope is going to come forward with a family remembrance.
So, as I walked this last year with Ted, so many times I had conversations with him about what would be best for him, what he should do, what he shouldn't do. I think I was his favorite nudge. I was always thinking about what would be best for him. But Ted had his own ideas. He was strong-willed and intelligent, and he knew what he wanted right up to the very end. So over the last year and even beyond that, when he would have health problems, people at the hospital, the nurses at the rehab center, they'd say, "Who are you? Who are you to Ted?" And I said, "Well, I'm family. We're cousins, sort of, by marriage, sort of." So just to kind of unravel the mystery of our relationship with Ted, my husband's uncle, Herb, married Ted's cousin, Marie. How could I forget Marie? Aunt Marie. And so Ted and Marie had known each other for many years, obviously. They were related, also by marriage. And I'm not even going to go into that. But when Uncle Herb passed away, we kind of inherited Marie, Aunt Marie. And with Aunt Marie, we inherited Ted, because Ted would often bring Marie to holiday gatherings. We would include them because they didn't really have anyone or any place to go. So that kind of went on for a while, and then Marie passed away, and then Ted became ours forever. He was at all of our holidays. He was Uncle Ted to our grandchildren, and just a great all-around guy. As I stand here now, I wish, as I always wish when I lose somebody near and dear, that I'd asked him more questions about his life. I did weasel some things out of him over my visits at the rehab center, but not nearly enough, because as Bill and I have been kind of beginning to sort through his things, we have found so many things that we didn't know about him, like he was valedictorian of his high school graduation class. Who knew? Bill's brother Jack graduated with Ted, and he never told us that. It's just so, Lord only knows, as we move forward in the next months, what else we're going to find out. Stay tuned, if you're interested. So anyway, I think Father Watkins mentioned quite a few things. Ted was an avid art collector, and he has quite a considerable collection that he is donating to the Cincinnati Art Museum. So, and apparently, as we discovered recently, he was a bit of an artist himself, as was his mother. Again, who knew? So I'm waiting to find some of Theodore Penker original artwork in his condo as we sort through. If we do, I'll let you know. So, and of course, Ted was also an avid fan of the arts, plays, theater, opera, symphony. One of the hardest things for him as he started his slow decline was not being able to get in his car and drive downtown to the symphony. That was just heartbreaking for him. And so I think the next time the symphony plays, Ted will probably be somewhere up in the balcony listening and enjoying the beautiful music. At least I'd like to think he is. So Teddy, we're gonna miss you, buddy. Christmas and Thanksgiving and Easter won't be the same without you. But I know that you're in a way better place and living it up, and no more pain, no more hardship. So God bless you, and God bless all of you who've come to be here with us today. We are having a little gathering at the Prima Vista after the burial, if you'd like to join us. And remember Ted some more. So blessings to you, and thank you for being here.
Thank you, Penelope. Please stand. Before we go our separate ways, let us take leave of our brother. May our farewell express our affection for him. May it ease our sadness and strengthen our hope. One day we shall joyfully greet him again when the love of Christ, which conquers all things, destroys even death itself. Father, mercies, we commend our brother Ted in the sure and certain hope that together with all who have died in Christ, he will rise with him on the last day. We give you thanks for the blessings which you bestowed upon Ted in this life. They are signs to us of your goodness and of our fellowship with the saints in Christ. Merciful Lord, turn toward us and listen to our prayers. Open the gates of paradise to your servant and help us who remain to comfort one another with assurances of faith until we all meet in Christ and are with you and with our brother forever. Through Christ our Lord. Amen.
In peace, let us take our brother to his place of rest.
Number 881, lift high the cross. Number 881.